Yeah. And we see he's painting from a reference. So I bet you we're going to get a nice figure out.
And here we are with Caleb Kieran.
Oh, I barely see anything there, but I think that maybe is like a little bit of camera effect. I think there is a sketch hiding under that.
Yeah, I think. Oh, when we see his shadow
Oh
pass over, we can get
yeah.
the sense of the pencil drawing that might be underneath there. And then it looks like he's adding some umber on top of here. And Kieran also teaches art as an art instructor and comes from a place of being self-taught himself. So I think that that's a really cool achievement, being a self-taught artist and honing all of these skills on your own and then getting them to a point that you become a teacher yourself. That's so cool.
Yeah, I do like that. And hopefully there's a couple of students in the audience here tonight.
I would not be surprised. I bet that there are. And then who are we here with now? Now we're back with Tiffany, I think. And
Great. I
something
wonder what
that,
she's up to here.
yeah,
I don't get it yet.
I think that she is doing that drawing technique. And I'm hoping that she adds some whites in there a little bit more prominently so that you can understand the painting better at a distance.
Realism.
Yeah.
I use a little bit of magic.
His sense of magical. And I'm hoping I saw that he was street art influenced, but I was mistaken. That was a different artist. Harvey is known for his sense of magical realism, where he's creating these portraits that also incorporate elements of nature and kind of surreal elements. So blending the real and the surreal, and describes his work as magical realism.
Oh, it's lovely
Which is
and
one of my
magical.
favorite descriptive words. Like, how do you paint
Yeah.
magical realism?
Magical realism.
Yeah.
I use a little bit of magic and
And a little bit of
right.
realism.
A little bit of realism.
Right. Oliver looks like he's doing a great job with this technique here. I'm liking the lighter elements on the inside of the wave. You're getting the sense of light that's being captured from that kind of sunset that he's got going on.
And though he hasn't taken like this sort of layered approach, it hasn't panned out yet, but it's one that we've seen used very, very successfully among some really talented artists at Art Battle, and I think generally in artist studios. It's a very layered approach to building this. We have a quite an artful sort of fundamental silhouette, and it's being and he's just going to keep adding the layers of detail here, I'm sure.
And hanging out with Caleb. And highly concentrated on this drawing.
It's beautiful. I love that we can see the reference there. So he's being very true to his reference. And I'm pretty sure this is a.
And Matthew often kind of blends abstracted elements with portraits to kind of set off softness of a portrait, or the again that kind of juxtaposition between realism and another element that is not realism. Wow, the quality the emotive quality of this portrait from Harvey is beautiful. You're really getting a sense of kind of like somberness from the palette, but also the way that he's punching in the highlights here.
I love The Wave. It's a great painting. I think it's really going to jive with the audience. It feels very, I don't know, it's the time of the season, you know? It's kind of a spring thinking about outdoors. And it's super vibrant.
And then back to the sponge technique as well. So
Yeah.
he is usually more in kind of the illustration realm. So to be seeing these kind of painterly techniques with a heavy application is something that I didn't expect from him. But I always love seeing artists painting in Art Battle, and you get a sense of their studio work in terms of like maybe the palette or the subject matter, but then you get a different flavor from their Art Battle technique. Places. It's not too high or low.
Like a scribble printer approach.
Yeah.
I love it. Wow.
Yeah, he's almost bouncing the marker.
Yeah. That is something. I hope we get in there tighter on the next pass.
And back with Matthew now. I wonder if these are mountains in this character's sunglasses. What do you think?
That does make sense.
And some headphones.
Are they broken, maybe, the glasses? No. Mountains. It's a guy who's skiing. He's checking out. He just smoked an amazing joint and he's gonna go down the hill.
And here we are with Tiffany as well. And I would love to get, oh, we're having to fight with the lighting just a little bit here, but we are getting kind of glimpses of this portrait here. Okay, because of the very careful placement, and that it's just being used as an accent, but it's also still playing into the general composition that he has going on there. Like, it's not too harsh of an accent.
Good point.
I bet the audience is loving this piece from Oliver. This is definitely one of the more vibrant pieces in the bunch.
Yeah, I bet you are the portrait from Dominic?
Oliver.
His name?
Oh,
Oh, no,
the portrait
I was just saying the two. I was just starting
from
to try to
Matthew.
pick our my two. Yes, exactly. Pick the two that might go on. I mean, obviously the audience is going to vote. Speaking of which, if you want to get in here and have your vote, you know where to do it. Artbattle.com/vote. You just throw in your phone number, you get a special voting link, and you can even bid on these paintings to add them to your collection. We'll mail that right over to you.
Look at the
Oh yeah.
feet. Look at the feet. They're so good. And they're so
Yeah,
warm.
the feet are almost as hard to do as the hands, and this has been a great job here.
Yeah, what an interesting pose to pick. We've seen quite a lot of nudes from the back in Art Battle, but to be incorporating hands and feet and this kind of like S posture, the curvature of the spine and the subtle tilt of the neck. It's a really beautiful, subtle posture.
Yes, I think so. And you were mentioning that he's a life drawing, so experienced in life drawing, and obviously that's coming through in a strong way right there.
The energy coming from this drawing technique is wonderful as well.
I'm really pleased that he's brought some color into it, and I don't know if that we're seeing that with the marker. I mean, is this I think this is a white marker over top of the previous black marker.
Oh, to
That's a
punch in some
very
highlights.
unusual, yeah, very unusual technique.
Okay, and we're getting some writing here from Matthew.
It's gonna be Bob Ross, I'm telling you. My
You were
God.
right. Like, we get quite the breadth of attitudes from artists. We get.
Oh man, writing is You gotta be
Oh,
really good at the
wait.
penmanship.
It's not Bob Ross. It's Bob
It's Bob Ross.
Rocks.
Well, at least there's a bit of humor in it, I think.
Love it when we get humorous paintings. It's so easy to
Me
take
too, me too.
take art so seriously. And I love the kind of like we get quite the breadth of attitudes from artists. We get artists that love to have a little joke and engage the audience with some humor, and then we have artists that are like, this is going to be the best painting that I've ever done in my whole life, and I'm going to Nationals right now. And so having that mix of personalities in a single round is really fun because you get to kind of bounce around between all of these different ideologies.
Definitely. And the fun ones are fun, and I don't think that they win as much, but they certainly create the vibe and the scene, and they let the other artists excel even further.
Definitely. Ooh, look at the highlights going on in this portrait's hair. I always love watching artists paint hair. It's so much in the wrist.
Yes.
And just bouncing his brush in the corner there. It's painted so carefully, but with such a wonderful sense of energy. And then you see him like smacking his brush at it, and it's so unexpected for how specific a painting it is. But I dig it. And we're getting a little bit of wave foam spatter from Oliver.
Oh yeah. He's got a lot of techniques up his sleeve. We've seen quite a few from the initial blocking of this, moving into it right away, the incredible breadth of palette. Really, I mean, the sunset paintings are something special to do, but I think he's really captured the light beautifully, moving in and around that wave.
And the colors in this piece are almost applied like a wash. Oh, we're getting our countdown. It's a really unique idea too. Like, I don't think I've ever seen a portrait of Bob Ross with his work in his glasses. So that's a cool, unique concept.
It is. It is. It's something.
And then
Ooh,
here with
this is a
Tiffany.
some really great profiles that were sort of still had depth somehow. And that one, it's there. You can see where he's going with it, but it's missing some of that sort of depth perfection.
And here we are with Oliver. Oh, I didn't even notice the mountains in the background too. That really grounds the horizon in a nice way.
Yeah. That's
He's based out of Ogden, Utah, inspired by graffiti walls in Mexico City and hip hop. Works with a mix of drawing, painting, photography, digital media, videography, and murals, primarily illustrated figures, mostly digital. And this is his first art battle. One more time for Leon. And our next artist at easel number three, put your hands together for V.O. Wolf. His competitor is 4S Art, inspired by the work as a paranormal investigator. That's right, she was a paranormal investigator. So I'm gonna see all sorts of magical, nightmarish stuff. She's working in oil, acrylic, pencil, crayon, charcoal, watercolor, and more. Also enjoys 3D mediums like welding, clay, wood, resin, and textiles. More time for V.O. Wolf. And our next artist at easel number four, we got the one and only Ferris. Make some noise for Ferris, y'all. Intuitive artist led by the sounds of his environment, often choosing vibrant palettes to depict a lively atmosphere. His art is lively, vibrant, and whimsical. Listens to the environment to dictate what kind of color schemes fit with what he paints. And he's like putting music on the canvas. Make some noise for Ferris. Woo! He's got all sorts of achievements and awards, but this is his first art battle ever. And he likes to party hard. That's the main thing you gotta know about this dude. All right, and at easel number 5, we got the legendary, the iconic, the one and only Heather Olsen. Make some noise for Heather. Heather's oil paintings explore connections between humans, animals, insects, and different species. And when I talked to her earlier, she mainly was like, I just like to paint animals. So make some noise for Heather. She is a veteran. Not only has she been battling since 2020, but she won the last art battle here. And our last realism. She also has been battling since 2020. So we got some veterans here in round 2. Make some noise for all the artists blessing us with their vibes tonight. We're gonna give them 60 seconds to get their paint out, and then round 2 will officially begin. Get your paint ready. Let's go.
All right. Hello and welcome back to Art Battle Salt Lake City for round number 2. We are having a lot of fun tonight at the easels. Lots of paint flying. The timer will be going momentarily for round number 2 with these 6 artists with 6 intimidating blank canvases before them. And they will have 20 minutes on the clock to paint and vie for your votes. So make sure that you go to artbattle.com/vote and register, because it's your job to pick the best artists tonight. My name is Morgan Booth, and I'm here with Simon Plashkes, Art Battle co-founder. Hi, Simon.
Hey, Morgan. Pumped to be here for round 2 in Salt Lake City.
Pump, pump, pumped. So these guys...
I think that organizers can't help. They typically pick the order of the rounds. I think they can't help but really stack round 2. You know, you don't want to put all your heavy hitters in round 1.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, you want to do as much to sort of distribute it around so it's fair for all the artists. But I think we're going to see a couple of pretty heavy hitters here in round 2.
Oh, we're looking at one at Lucky Easel number 5 right now, Heather Olsen. She's a killer.
She is amazing. If you haven't seen it, we'll try to show you that fox that she did in round 1 at the Midwest Regional Championships. That was one of the best art battle paintings of the year, for sure.
Yeah, it was incredible. She little blip there, but we're back. Yeah, she just competed on Friday, was it? At the Midwest Regional Championship.
Yeah, she's back already.
And made it to the final round.
Did you see our first artist here on round 1? She did a light spray on the canvas before she started. I love that prep.
20 minutes on the clock. Oh, and look, I think that this is Shanna. And she's using the back of her hand as a palette already.
Oh my god. Is that her trademark?
That's cool. I wonder if Shanna was a makeup artist in any past lives.
I do not know about this technique. I mean, it makes perfect sense. You have it right there. It's on the skin.
And the crowd loves it too. The crowd always really is so into that.
And you can leave it on your hands after, you can leave it on your arm after it dries, after the round, kind of like, you know, like a badge of honor of having done the battle. Some battle wounds.
So who is this? I didn't see the easel number. Who are we hanging out with right now?
I don't know, but I love this sketch. It feels very geometric, very sort of astronomical to me here. I think
So this is
it's a
Leon
bowl.
Arujo. Yeah, and definitely getting that astronomy vibe. I w almost wanted to whip out like a giant compass to.
Yeah. And do a little bit of math. Do a little bit of math on there, you know, solve some real problems.
Okay, I think I know where we're going with Vile Wolf. I feel like I need to say the full name because I think that's their artist name, Vile Wolf, like Beowulf,
Yeah,
only
Vile
violet.
Wolf.
So
There you go.
cool. So many cool people in our battle, right?
Absolutely. Salt Lake City is filled with characters, so I'm sure a good percentage of them are here at our battle tonight.
And Beowulf often works in horror themes. And I'm getting kind of a little bit of like a Reaper meets Virgin Mary vibe from the painting that we just saw her working on. And here we are with Ferris Alawi, or El Alawi. And Ferris's studio work is like beyond. I'm so excited to see Ferris paint in this round. So if you guys aren't aware of him, he's Ferris Art Studio on Instagram, and his work is just super textural, very, very painterly, great at capturing likenesses, but very emotive likenesses. So can't wait to see where this portrait's going. It looks like we've already got a strong sketch going down.
Yeah, it's an interesting palette too. It's a bit you know, murdery for my taste so far, but I think there's a lot, you know, this is obviously just the first layer or the first and second layer. So I think, you know, we have a good opportunity to see this come into its own, but it may very well remain murdery, and a lot of people are into that.
That's what happens when you start your ground with crimson, I guess. Oh man,
Oh
Heather,
my
this is
God.
not fair.
Heather.
Heather, this isn't fair.
Oh,
This is like
I
4 minutes
feel
in,
that we
guys.
are. It really isn't fair. So we'll have to see. We'll have to see. But
She's so
she's
good.
obviously the one to beat. She won at Salt Lake City in the previous show, and she came to represent in the qualifying event in the national qualifier in Chicago. And she's been practicing, and she's the one to beat. If you can beat her, you probably win the show.
Ooh, here we are with Shanna. And Shanna, I'm really, really excited about this composition because I was doing the artist research earlier today and was super excited about some of the wolf pieces that she had going on. Shanna does a lot of animal pieces, but her wolves in particular were really cool
Wow.
and impactful. And like, look at all
Look
these
at
different colors.
the palette of this, the sort of color blocking, but it's blended color blocking, and it's very shade driven, obviously. And it's, I mean, right now it looks a bit wild. wild animal wolf wasn't on purpose. But I think that I bet you she's going to polish it into something absolutely stunning.
I think you had a really great comment there too about color blocking, but it's blended color blocking because we never see that. You always see kind of
Yeah.
one or the other. So I'm really interested in that technique. And I
Yeah,
believe that this
exactly.
is. No. I think that we're coming up on Sunshine Tyndall. Great name, another great name. We've got a lot of good names going on.
We're having trouble seeing this painting in its full form, but I love what I see here. I don't know if we're paused here on the red, the sort of red white blocks, The super painterly transitions between these color blocks are, I'm really into it. I hope we get to see more of it here.
I'm almost seeing a heart shape.
Yeah.
Bear with us, guys. It's a hard thing beaming all of this
Yeah.
concentrated creativity into the internet's eyeballs.
The internet is a tricky place. This is all wireless. But they're I hear from the camera team they're going to try a thing or two, so stick with us for just a couple more moments and we will have some art battle action.
And in the meantime, let's check out the auction and see what the pieces from round number one were looking like. Oh, and I believe we are back. And who are we with now? We're back with Leon. And this approach is so graphic driven, so careful. That lemon slice, the way that
I
it's
guess
described
that's.
with these dark lines.
Is that a lemon slice? Is that fruit? Yeah, I guess so.
And then
It
the.
looks like half. It looks like half of a film, old school film canister reel. But it is obviously a lemon. It is
Yeah.
obviously a lemon, I guess. Yeah, there's the lemon color.
But cool technique though, with the drawing that was definitely done in a marker, and then this application over top of the marker, and then the smart ass remark, is this an NFT at the top? I feel like this piece is gonna have
Good,
people talking all
good.
day.
You know, like that. You know, we should be messing with that stuff more. But you know, he's probably got an NFT collection. It's actually promo.
Yeah. Oh, and here we are back with Beowulf. And the gesture of these hands. Wow, this character's so ominous. But check out the
Whoa.
glow that's coming in from out from the side of the character.
I love that it's gold on one side and silver on the other. That is choice.
Oh, I didn't catch that. Good catch.
I think that's what's going on there. It's like I don't know. It's even more magical somehow because the let's call them the magician or not the magician, but the wizard is in sort of the center of this swirl of of magic. It really sets them as the focal point.
Yeah, and this kind of. I wonder if we're gonna get any face or not. I almost hope that we don't because this cowl is. It's creeping me out in a good way.
A very powerful piece. I can see on their timer on the stage there, we got 9 minutes and 56 seconds left.
Yes.
Oh, look at this piece. See, this is the one that was a little murdery, right?
Yes, from Ferris.
And we've pulled it back into life. It's a very alive painting now. I love this with these big glasses.
Yeah, and the skin, the super warm skin tone coming through, and then you can see that the drawing, in or the base drawing that all of this was layered on top of, has been done in a really deep like purple. And I think it's just lending a really cool depth.
Very cool. And the big right the big excuse me big red sort of area on the left there on the collar. I don't know. I'm not sure what's going on there, but I'm excited by it. It really does the job.
Yeah,
We're gonna get more
definitely.
of that, obviously.
And especially that Varys is now coming in with a knife too. Lots of really immediate energy in that piece. And here we are again with Heather and this insane 11-minute painting this is just absolutely gorgeous barn owl. And something that I always really appreciate from Heather's work is that the faces of the animals that she does are so detailed, and then as you kind of go outward into the body, it becomes more expressionistic.
Yeah, I didn't notice that. But yeah, it's sort of the hyper detail, and probably it helps her time her work better. If she gets a little more time, she can sort of move the detail out further.
Yeah, excellent strategy.
We saw that from Victoria Gomez Mayol in the in the online championship.
Yes. Yeah, good point.
This
And
is fantastic. I love the, painterly color blocking business of the feathers. I mean, it actually looks like that in the picture. So it's pretty cool to have it be represented in this way. Oh my God, look at this magic wolf.
I'm so into it. The
It's so majestic.
it's so majestic, and it's also like it has elements of like fauvism and cubism. It's just really
It's a very
wonderful.
cubist palette.
And when I'm saying fauvism is really known as like how kind of coming in and around the same time, a little bit after cubism, I believe, but is more primarily known for its use of unconventional colors. We're absolutely seeing that here from Shanna. This piece is so cool. This is a painter's painting.
It's really something. The structure of the wolf's face is kind of distorted a little, but in a way that the logic completely comes through. Each way that is distorted is consistent with the next, with sort of the slightly blockier mouth, and then these sort of eyeshadow-y lines. Very, very cool.
Yeah, love that piece. And here we are with Sunshine, and
Is this a
Sunshine
heart?
is creating a very dark piece.
So funny that somebody with the artist named Sunshine is going to show. I was talking about murdery paintings. Well, this one's still in the murdery category. But hey, some people love that, like I said.
And still using the her hand technique, and I think. Does she actually have plastic on her hand to use that as a palette? That's
Yeah, she.
so
That's
cool.
right. That
That's
is
so
so cool. That is
cool.
smart. I think she's just tape on her hand. She's got tape on her hand. She's
Yeah, it's
whew,
like tape
that's a
or
good
like
first.
tattoo cover or something like that. That's a first. And wow, that's so interesting. Every time we see Art Battle in all of these different cities, I always find something to be like, whoa. Never seen that before. Like it's and like special nerdy painter techniques.
Yeah, exactly.
5 minutes
That's what
on
we're
the
looking
clock.
for.
And the top two artists from this round will join the top two artists from round number one, in the final face-off, in round number three. The top four artists will have a new canvas. And we'll battle it out all over again for your votes, and one winner will emerge from the night. Once again, we're in Salt Lake City tonight, hanging out with all the really cool artists in the area.
I really like this NFT one. It's
Yeah,
fun.
Leon's having
It's
fun with it and also doing a careful exit. He's having a joke, but also a careful execution within that joke, which I appreciate.
And I like the designy aspect of this. You know me, I'm always arguing against writing on paintings, but at least it's got its own little section, like it's up there. In a way, the painting of the lemon, this like designy lemon, can sort of still exist on its own as a painting.
Yeah, and then you see in the other quadrant, like it's almost as if this is like a Photoshop or an Illustrator screenshot. You're seeing the palette that's being used is like in little squares on the side there. Very funny, that painting.
Oh, I was sure you, I think you got it. I think that's right. It's kind of the software that he's using to design this 3D lemon model.
Well, that's the most meta painting that I've seen all season,
It's
for
very
sure.
meta. What will be really meta is if we make an NFT out of that painting.
Leanne, we will DM you. Okay, Beowulf. This piece just keeps getting better and better every time we circle around it. There are some really subtle blends here, and it's just retaining its ominous nature without going into a place that's too grotesque.
And I think there, the in the face, it's obviously covered with the cowl, but there's a tiny little bit of face shadow shape that's coming through that. I don't know. I think that's intentional.
I think so too. It's like the where the cowl
The
would go
nose and the
over the
eye
brow
kind of.
bone.
Yeah, exactly. Very cool. Is she wearing a painting? Is that a cool shirt, or is that she paint that?
It's I think it's like a lace skeleton rib cage situation. Very on brand.
That's very off-brand, yeah.
All right, Ferris. This piece is so good.
Yes, it is. Do you recognize the figure?
I don't. Do you?
Yeah, I don't know who it is, but it looks really familiar. It's like my long lost brother or something.
Well, it's definitely the figure definitely has like Burning Man glasses. So,
Yes.
probably I wouldn't say that it's unexpected that you would have met a character that looks like this.
Yeah, I think I have. I met this guy. And Salt Lake City is actually not too far from the Black Rock Desert.
This really. Oh, we're getting a signature now too, and just in time. We've got 1 minute left on the clock, and I love that Ferris just signed the piece and then went right back in to get the finishing touches. So we had kind of a prioritization there of like, okay, it's finished. Oh, wait.
Well, overpainting is always the risk in our battle, but I think Ferris is a real pro, as we see here with Heather. I don't think we have to worry. I think they're going to make use of every stroke in a positive light.
And first battle for Ferris as well. And man, this piece by Heather is so great, and she's done the background in such an intelligent way too, keeping it just really stark and dark to create this contrast against the snowiness of this album. Okay, getting the countdown, gonna throw to the venue audio.
Three, two, one, round two is complete. Make some noise. Yeah. Extraordinary levels of talent. Blessed with the best.
Wow, the finishing pieces on this wolf here. And the way that the eyes came through, this piece has such a unique energy. Well, what a round. So, once again, for anyone that is out there watching, You are going to help us choose who moves on to the third and final round. So, top two artists from round number one, top two artists from round number two, will move on to the final. So, voting is open now for this round at artbattle.com/vote. So, make sure that you support these artists with your votes. We've been hearing more and more lately that voting can be absolutely neck and neck. So, don't think that your vote doesn't count. Or it doesn't matter. It super, super does. And I know that these artists will appreciate it. All of the works have been created tonight are also available for silent auction. So if you've been falling in love, as we have been throughout this round and throughout this night, of awesome live art, make sure that you get in there and bid. We will ship them to you. And we will be back super soon with round number three.
Wow, we have four incredible artists coming up. I guess you guys might not have heard, so we'll let you know exactly who is coming up if you didn't hear on that stream. We've got coming up from round one, we have Benedict Halsey, and also from round one, Caleb Sarand, and from round two, Heather Olson and Ferris Alawi. This is going to be an absolutely killer round, Morgan.
I'm so excited.
Truly, I
I
mean,
know
we were saying earlier.
you guys always hear me say I'm so excited, but guys, I am so excited. I love watching live painting. And it's always, oh man, it's a thrill when you really want to see the final round artists paint again. Like I chose not to vote. Because sometimes our Battle HQ, you don't vote. Sometimes you do. But I really did want to see all four of these artists paint again. I was really curious about their techniques. And so it feels like a treat that we get another 20 minutes with them, in their live studios.
Yeah, each of these artists has a very, very well-defined approach, and I think we're probably going to see it again. I think to depart from what got them there, at least in terms of the technique, would be a mistake for any of these artists. They each sort of really stand on their own, and it will be very interesting to see what their strategies are for different for you know well they stick most likely with that technical approach, what differences they do offer. Because you don't want to do the same painting twice. The audience, you know, the audience does not prefer that. But at the same time, you don't want to depart too much from what it was that got you there. So it's a real head game for these artists here tonight.
And another fun element too is that three of the four artists that have made it to the final round and are painting again, this is their first art battle. This is their first time.
Wow, and they're up against a super heavyweight in Heather Olsen. I know that she's sort of revisited the strategy that she employed at the Midwest Regional Finals, and what I'm talking about is that I mean, I'll speak frankly from my own opinion here, but I think that her first painting was stronger and resonated more with the audience than the second one. So you know, and but that's very common, by the way. That's not
Yeah,
saying
it's
anything
part of the game.
anything negative against Heather, but I bet you that she's got a really, really banging plan for the second painting. And so with these other three artists who are in their first battle, that's sort of where you see one of the ways that you see the difference between an experienced battler and somebody who's just coming up. Because you know you got to paint a better painting the second round, and most people give it their all in round one.
Yeah, it's and I think a lot of people underestimate the level of energy expenditure that can happen. It's a lot. It's a lot painting in your qualifying round, and then you're in shock and awe. Or maybe you're not. Maybe you're super confident and you're like, "Oh yeah, of course I made
Yeah, it depends who you are and how many
it."
Red Bulls you've had.
That's true.
But yeah.
But now you got to bring a whole new composition to another blank canvas, and a whole, you got to dig deep for that extra final round energy. This is boss level here.
Boss level, exactly. And speaking of boss level, the boss level of boss levels is
Boss level
coming
of
up
boss level.
so soon. It's Tuesday the 22nd today, and on April the 2nd, which is not this Saturday but next Saturday, we will have the top live artists in the whole country gathering in Wichita Falls, Texas for the 2022 U.S. National Championships. And that is, I mean, it's just what you think it's going to be, which is an unbelievable night of live competitive painting talent. Only one artist, just the same exact format as you see here tonight. It should be 12 artists in competition. We go from six and six down to four finalists and one winner. And that one winner is going to become the U.S. champion, and they will go on to represent the United States in the World Championships, which are scheduled to be in early 2023. So the stakes literally could not be higher in the live painting game for Art Battle coming up in the next couple of weeks. So I really hope that you'll mark your calendars and tune in with us on the 2nd of April.
It's going to be absolutely epic.
It truly is. And, you know, and like we were talking about Heather being the person to beat here, you know, the one who sort of stands above from both her experience and you know, the talent or the quality of her work and so on and so forth. The person to beat at the national championships is the last national champion that was a pre-COVID winner from Dragon 76. And now, if you're not familiar with his work, go check it out. Art Battle, it's on the Art Battle page, or you can go to Instagram, Dragon 76 Art. Just Google Dragon 76 on IG or whatever. But he is an absolute giant in this field of live painting. You know, we don't do betting on it, although maybe we should. But certainly he's the odds, if not being full in his favor, it's pretty close. He, despite all the competition, he's so good. But you know, we do have some people who are going to give him a run for his money. I think both. Well, I mean, all the artists, of course, they're all a finalist. But just to speak of a couple here, I'm super excited about Juju from. He's actually from Chicago, but he won at the LA. He's won the LA spot. So his work is so great, don't you
And
think, Morgan?
how cool is that, to be a traveling artist and to win, in a city where you don't have the hometown advantage? And he qualified, in Los Angeles as well for his event that got him to the finals. So not only did he win, without a hometown advantage once, he did it twice.
Yeah, he's quite the guy, and he really really wanted it. He went to San Francisco, he went to LA, he's competed in Chicago, and now he's headed to Texas. He's headed to Wichita Falls, and he'll be representing a lot of different people and communities, all the folks who voted for him in LA, and they that crowd absolutely loved him. I didn't look at this particular vote count, so I'm not speaking of the votes here, but the crowd seemed to be heavily favor him, and they were thrilled when he won. This is
Yeah.
not, you know, sometimes you get it and you half the crowd's like, my friend didn't win or whatever it is, but this crowd was totally behind him, and I'm sure they'll all be thrilled to see him participate and represent them at Nationals.
Yeah, he has a very engaging painting style, absolutely.
And yeah, it feels both his process and the finished work are, it feels very alive, organic. There's storytelling in it, and it's a beautiful contrast to Dragon's work, which is a lot sharper. I mean, still stories, but they feel like fantastical stories in Dragon's case. It's a bit of sort of feels a bit sort of anime almost,
Yeah.
and something about Juju's work, the stories feel sort of internal stories, right? Like the characters that are presented there. It's almost like it's that movie, you know, where the girl has the feelings in her head, and they all have different characters or whatever, you
Oh,
know?
yeah, I know what you're talking about, but I can't think of the
Yeah,
name right
the
now.
feels, or I
On
don't know.
Facebook,
Anyway, that's a
let
great
us
movie,
know.
but I mean, I don't know if that, to, you know, I mean, this is my, you know, really bird's eye interpretation of Juju's work there, but there's these characters there, and they feel like they're sort of connected and they're one. So maybe there's an element of that, like the multiple voices in our heads, which to me is a much more sort of emotionally grounded approach than the like the super fantasy of the dragon world. So a great juxtaposition.
Yeah, and good point there that you're saying, like, this is just my interpretation. Like, that's the whole point of this shebang, you know? With the everyone casting their vote in their own individual interpretation. And we just are so lucky that we get to highlight all of these artists and be the stage that provides everybody with the opportunity to check out all of these different vantage points of art, all of these different styles, and for each person to have a unique interpretation. You know, like there could be 100 people in the room and they're each thinking something different, interpreting each painting. And I think that's such a beautiful thing and a really unique way to experience art.
It's very special. It's a rare view inside. I'm totally engaged by this intense conversation that these guys are having here. I wonder what's going on.
They're not.
I think that I think she's trying to convince him to switch up the reference. Like, no, paint me.
Yeah, or... she's very intense with intensely
she is
talking
so intense.
To.
I wonder what's going on there. Well, I think she's pitching. They're talking strategy. They are talking art battle strategy.
I love
this
that.
Isn't like, honey, you didn't put the casserole in the oven like I told you to. No, this is definitely art battle strategy meeting.
Yeah.
And, she wants him to win, and she's saying, if you go this way, I think you're going to win.
So
it's
intense.
Very cool. Yeah, it's so intense. It's great.
Whoa,
meanwhile, Heather's chilling over here.
Is that a portrait reference? For Heather?
It is.
That's exciting. She definitely does do a lot of portraits in her studio work. I've just never personally seen her do one at Art Battle. So I'm
she's been
very
super
excited.
Animal oriented at Art Battle. But this is what I was talking about, right?
Strategy.
I think that she realizes she needs to mix it up a little in the in that final round. She's got to be, not a brush has touched a canvas, but I'd say, she's got slightly better than 50% odds on winning this whole thing here tonight. But
she also has a glass palette, guys. If you missed my opening remarks about Benedict and his glass palette, I'm like, the pros, they got glass palettes.
How do you clean it? Like with a razor blade?
Yeah, with a razor or like a glass scraper. And these are the artists that have better studio hygiene than I do. If I had a glass palette, I would never clean it.
Yeah, well, eventually you could just... Oh, you're in oils. I was going to say you can peel it off, but not quite true if it's oil.
Oh, a good acrylic peel is so satisfying.
It is so satisfying. That smooth underside. Ooh.
I feel like maybe at some point we should... do some like paint peeling ASMR and just put it on between rounds.
Oh, that's a great idea. Yeah, or some palette smears, some slow motion palette smears from back in the day.
Yes, please describe that to us.
Well,
tell us about how paintings used to meet their end with a smear.
Yeah, going way back, we this is sort of pre-auction. Much more of a demonstration essentially. And if the painting didn't sell at auction or if it truly was before we even were auctioning paintings, we destroyed the paintings. And it sounds so harsh to say it now, and in fact it really was. And so we only probably did it a handful of times before we realized let's just sell all the paintings instead. It's a lot less harsh than yours. But we tried a couple of different ways of so-called destruction. We did the pour, where you would take much more liquidy paint and completely pour it over the painting. So often we house paint, so basically completely obliterated the painting. And actually, there was a couple of paintings that were like we had full-on gasps and horror from the audience. Thinking of one in particular, was it a painting by Venus, I think. And it was like this beautiful little, like sort of small sketch, and it didn't win, and we obliterated it by pouring over house paint.
Yeah, that was so divisive, but it was definitely a part of the performance aspect of that kind of early iteration of Art Battle. And I think that I had a painting destroyed back in those early days as well. And
did you?
I felt a thrill. I think it was a palette smear.
So the palette smear,
it's thrilling.
The highest evolution the highest evolution of the painting structure and the most efficient from a paint use perspective was actually taking the artist's own palette so that it matched, and taking the palette and then putting it paint side on the canvas and then smearing it down the canvas. So it effectively wiped out almost all of the painting behind it, but it did it with the same palette, so the colors all match. So a lot of these palette smear paintings are actually super beautiful. One might argue they're more beautiful than the paintings that were there before. That was fun. That was worthwhile. I'm glad we don't do it still, but it's nice to have it in the archives.
Yeah, the kind of different evolutions of the growth of art battle and all of the different ways that art wins and loses. We're getting so close here to round number three. I'm hearing our MC is saying that painting is imminent. So these guys are gonna have another 20 minutes on the clock, and another blank canvas. And I don't think you can underestimate how intimidating a blank canvas can be, when it's just this big white square that's kind of staring up at you, and then you've got a crowd at your back. It's a really intense feeling. It can be intimidating, but also really thrilling. I know that I get a big energy boost at this point, when I've been in competitions past.
I mean, you have to. It's kind of like do or die now, especially for these artists here in the final round.
And I'm interested in this technique here of what is going on with this easel. It's so low, so I'm thinking that we're gonna get some strange happenings here.
This is still with that same team, this duo here, who's doing a lot of art battle strategy. And look, in comparison, Heather's canvas and easel setting looks so high.
Yeah, so
So
that's
funny.
at like a regular standing height. So is this Caleb or Ferris? Who is this?
I think it's Caleb.
So he's got something up his sleeve with this strange easel setup for sure.
So he's going to be at easel two or four,
Yeah.
right? Let's
I
see
can't
here
wait to
if
see
we
what
have.
happens, but also my knees are hurting just looking at him.
Easel two is Caleb, easel four is Ferris. So I guess it could be either. I think it's Caleb if it's going clockwise. Oh man, this is exciting! We're almost there.
So close, so
Come on,
close.
let's do it.
Next round coming up. I can't wait to see what Benedict does. I'm pretty confident that we'll get another nude figure from him, given that that's his specialty. But I can't wait to see him paint again, and I hope that I can get even a little bit more insight into his process and just how he creates the warmth in the skin tones.
Yes. Yeah, a real education there.
And we're getting confirmation that it has been Caleb that's been doing all of this strategizing. And we're seeing, even just in front of his easel, also, there's a lot more colors than we saw on his palette in his qualifying round. So I think we're gonna get a really different approach here. I don't think that we're gonna see the same that scribble printing technique. I think we're gonna get a totally different curveball. Oh, throwing to venue audio.
Beautiful, beautiful energy. Let's get all the final artists up here to the canvases. We about to pop off round three. Last reminder, we're going to move again in a clockwise direction. And let's just give our cameraman over here to him the dope shots. Just a little bit of space so he can really get up close and get those epic shots. And that way everybody wants to come our battle with us. Officially begun. Make some noise for all the artists in round three. Let's turn up the energy. Heather coming in strong.
From round number two, and these guys are gonna kill it. I'm excited. It's gonna be a great round. My name is Morgan Booth, and I'm here with our pedal co-founder Simon Plashkis.
Hey, Simon. Hey, Morgan.
Can't wait to see a portrait from Heather, and this reference is also gorgeous too.
Yeah, amazing. But you know what's gonna be so similar to some of the other work? I don't know if it's more a problem for our other artists than Heather, I would imagine. But very exciting.
It's going to be a figure-heavy
portrait. Figure-heavy for sure. I mean, it makes sense for the final round. It's a safe bet. That's what the audience wants to see. So we can see that time to time. Yeah.
And also, interesting approach from Heather here, too, is that the reference is in black and white. And she's working in color.
That's cool. So there's a lot of imagination coming into it. Appreciate that.
And here we are with Caleb. And I believe he's painting on his knees. And already...
Why?
Yeah. Reveal to us.
What is... Because he did in the first round. I don't even know what to make of it. It's funny because there's a strategy. I don't know. Maybe we're going to see... Maybe we're going to see it coming up real soon.
Yeah, and even in just these 2 minutes, we're seeing a huge departure from Caleb's first piece, in that his first piece was lots and lots of negative space and very drawing heavy, and there's lots of paint on the canvas already. So definitely more of a painting approach and less of an illustrative approach, which was what got him to the final round. So we'll see if his audience likes that.
Indeed.
Okay, and Benedict here.
Doing it in a landscape orientation. Still going to be a figure. Oh, look, oh, you can see the from the reference where we're going. Oh man, this
So
is going to be
cutesy.
such a tough battle. You voters are going to have a tough time. You better get your what do they call those? Your rubrics out, or your planogram scorecards,
Your
and to determine
planogram.
what is in fact important to you. What matters to you as an art battle voter, because you only get to vote for one. So you got to
Yeah,
figure it out.
and only one winner will emerge victorious from this final round, and will earn their place in the next Salt Lake City Championship or the next regional championship, because this is the start of a new season for SLC, right?
Yes, it is.
Who's gonna claim that first spot?
Well, it's going to be one of these artists here tonight.
I like that Benedict has chosen this strategy again, where he's done a really concentrated underpainting and has kept a lot of negative space around. I think it'll make for a really beautiful companion piece. But I would say that I'd be worried about it being too close to his first round piece, but I know that the technical prowess is just going to be so undeniable that I don't think that that's going to be very much of an issue.
I can't believe what a treat we have here with these four paintings. Look at this. Where I don't know where we're going with this, but I love where we are now, and I want to be along for the journey.
Yeah,
This
look at this
palette with
palette.
this sort of this palette knife blending technique is second to none. It's really top quality here.
It's like a forest fire at night is what I'm seeing, but of course it's so abstract that it could be anything, and it could just be abstract. It could be anything and nothing.
Yeah, you know what, the palette, and indeed the sort of anything and nothing, is very Gladstonian of him, if you know what I mean.
I do know what you mean. Simon is
Yeah.
referencing an artist that we know and love, Julie Gladstone, who uses figurative elements within abstracted shapes, or perhaps the opposite is true. But yeah. And here we are with Heather as well, and she's done a very similar technique to Benedict. Here,
Yeah,
it
I don't
looks
know
like
if they
she's the Zoom
realize.
view. I don't think she realizes
Yeah.
it, or I don't think either of them realize, because they're at opposite ends, and of course they can't see each
Right,
other.
right.
But both of them have laid down this warm, kind of this warm brown sienna-ish ground, and then are placing a figure on top of that and allowing for negative space surrounding. So it's almost like Heather's doing a zoomed view of the figure that Benedict is doing. So could be competing for the same vote pool.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. This actually might be the thing that takes Heather out from the top spot, because these paintings in palette, in sort of, into roughly in style, are pretty similar. So that's a tough move.
Yeah, tough move all around. What's Caleb up to? Let's go visit Caleb. Mushrooms? Question mark?
I don't know.
I don't see a reference.
It's definitely mushroomy at the bottom, but you don't do mushrooms on mushrooms. It could be gnomes.
Gnomes
Those
on
are
a
it's
mushroom?
gnomes. It's gnomes on a mushroom, and there's going to be a big gnome in the middle.
Oh,
Oh
that's
my God,
fun.
it's great.
That's so much fun. And a good prediction from you, I think, at this early stage of the build out of this painting. I do get the impression of like a bit of a forest situation going on in the background. Oh, look, we're getting the main gnome's big nose. I also love thinking about the strategy meeting that we just watched
Yeah,
happening,
okay,
like
so
paint the gnomes. You
this
gotta
is the
paint the
result of the
gnomes.
strategy meeting. You gotta do the gnomes, babe. If you don't do the gnomes. Oh my gosh, that's fantastic.
Well, it's already connecting to me on a endearing level, so still wondering why he's so low.
Fantastic, really good.
Okay, swimming around to Benedict.
Oof. I mean, this is such a contender versus Heather's painting that I don't even know. I'm glad. I mean, it's going to be tight. I was saying that she's going to take it, but that is not the case here.
Well, we don't know. We're only halfway through, and yeah, I do. I agree with you that I think that it's going to be. These two are competing for the figurative vote because we have gnomes, I guess, are people, but that's not going to count toward the figurative vote. And then last time we were hanging out with Ferris, it was very abstracted. So Benedict and Heather will be competing for the figure lovers in the room tonight. And the gesture of this figure is so beautifully done, and there's a lot of warmth here, but there's also a coolness in the shadows that I don't think that I picked up on in his first round painting. And I think it's adding a really great sense of roundness. And I'm wondering, looking at this palette, is this oil? Because I'm seeing that little jar on the little desk that he's got going on there.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm wondering if Benedict is doing this piece all in oil.
Well, that would be really something.
I think he is.
It feels oily.
Yeah, it definitely feels oily in the quality of the kind of buttery blending.
He's so good. Is this pure abstract? I love it. Oh my God.
Ferris.
I have to vote in this round for this painting if this is pure abstract.
I feel like it's a landscape, but I feel like it's a landscape that is just a suggestion, and that the real...
Mm-hmm.
That the real basis of the painting is this beautiful color play, and then you look into the sky, or what I'm perceiving as the sky, and the swirling texture.
No, you're right. It's like the greatest Aurora Borealis ever.
I swear, you guys, you do really need to go see Ferris's work on Instagram at Ferris Art Studio, because this is not unique to his live painting. All of his studio work has this incredible moving, textural, vibrating quality as well. Ooh, Heather. She could pull ahead with the florals. The added florals bring a lot of interest here. And we are also seeing that she's deviating from the reference quite a lot. She's not using the reference for her color story. And she's invented these flowers as well. I like seeing that, because you're seeing her brain interpreting the reference in real time.
That's really great, because most of the time, of course, we see just a pretty faithful reproduction of the reference. And here, not only are we getting the addition of, you know, a substantial amount of color from this black and white reference, but the flowers, so great.
So she must have just fallen in love with the proportions of her reference's face, and then decided to do the color interpretation on her own. That's a brave take. I don't think I'd be brave enough to do that. That's a hard one, but she's doing it intuitively and she's doing a great job. So three gnomes. Our gnomey friends. I'd love to get some polka dots on our
I don't the mushroom. Know. Remind me, is this the artist who did the sort of scratchy technique?
Yes. So big departure.
I don't even know what to say. I mean, it's a different guy up there painting. He's got two personalities, one where he's standing and one where he's kneeling. This is the playful kneeling personality.
This is the Caleb that comes from the woodlands. I like the dots. I'm so pleased when I say something that I want about a painting and then I immediately get it. So 6.5 minutes on the clock. How much more honing is Caleb going to do here? We're going to get some line work surrounding the gnomes to sharpen them up a little bit. Or is he going to stay loose like this? I also love...
I think we're seeing it stay loose. I think that, you know, going for... be a lot of line work to do pretty precisely with some fairly wet paint around it.
Yeah.
So it's probably going to be soft like this.
Okay, and heading on over to Benedict. And 5 minutes on the clock, so big reminder to everyone out there that your job is very important to help us choose the winning artist tonight. So go to artbattle.com/vote and register to vote if you have not already. Every vote counts, and these guys are painting their hearts out. So make sure that you support them with your voting opinion. I like the way that Benedict has grounded the figure here, again, with the use of bringing the contrast in through the fabric. That's what he did in his first round piece, and it really grounded it for me.
What do you mean through the fabric? Like, what the figure's lying on?
Yeah, what the fabric that the figure is lying on, like, I'm just getting a sense of, like, pillows or... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a big
purple duvet or something. And the purple is a nice contrast to this the golden tones that we're getting in the skin and also in the initial underpainting. I appreciate how gestural the parts leading out of the figure are that are going into the negative space are. It's just really, it's starting to involve the negative space in a way
right.
That's more holistic.
It's suggestive. It sort of, it tells you that it's there, but that it wasn't necessary to paint, basically.
Yes.
It's like here, the figure is so much the focus that the background is sort of invisible, but it's there enough to tell you what should be there.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, I'm excited to see Ferris's piece. Come on, camera guy, get in there.
He's doing it.
Wow, Ferris. Oh my goodness. Is this a forest fire? That was my initial impression. What do you think?
These yellow flames that are coming in here are certainly speaking in that direction.
It's so beautiful. It has just such
a
unique energy.
Really amazing.
And the fact that the darkness in the bottom quadrant of the painting is purple, is providing that good coolness against the warmth of the sky. And that's a technique that we actually did see in his first round qualifying piece with the figure. His shadows were purple and the skin tones were warm. So very different pieces, but elements carry on.
Yeah, love it.
Okay, just about 2 minutes left in the final
round. This voting, It's gonna be crazy. You only get one vote, and to cast your one vote, you need to go to artbattle.com/vote, put in your name and phone number, and we will send you a personal voting and bidding link. And you can use that to vote and even bid on these paintings. If you're not at the venue, as most of you hearing my voice now are probably not at the venue, don't worry, we will ship these paintings to you, or you can pick them up there at the venue if you're in Salt Lake. Yeah, just go for it. These are all really collectible paintings that I think that anyone would be happy to have it in their home and in their collection. So don't miss out.
The warmth of the ear here. I'm enjoying. That's always one of my favorite parts of portrait painting is seeing how the artist executes ears, because often you get this light that can go through the cartilage of an ear and it makes the ear really red. And I think that when an artist brings in that detail, it just brings such a wonderful sense of life into the portraits. Also, ears are really, really hard to paint.
Yeah,
They're
I really
such
think the hair
strange
has been done
shapes.
nicely here. The hair is a
Yes,
little easier,
yes.
and here it's fairly abstract. I don't even know. I mean, this is a good painting, and actually, it's really come through. It's all up to the audience now, both in person and you guys here with us.
We're having fun with this piece.
I just I, well, I can't, I'm blown away, but I can't believe this is the same artist with our a scratchy double portrait technique from the first round. So, but there you go.
Yes. Oh, here's our countdown.
Five, four, three, two, one, round three is
Oh, and the final last minute edition of the heart there from Caleb. Okay, this round is officially over. Just seeing the jubilance in the room right now, the celebration of the artists having just completed these 20-minute pieces, and everyone's so excited, and all of the artists are going to see everybody else's work.
Yeah, great energy. You can see people dancing around. They're having a blast. I think that it's a real honor to be in the presence of these four artists and these four pieces. They're all amazing. And the audience and even you guys here online are sort of with us. You've joined us. We're sort of a part of it, which is kind of one of the magical parts of Art Battle.
And we've absolutely had some magic here tonight, especially in the final round. These pieces are so full of life.
Votes are coming in. I'm going to go check and see just how many. We can give you some kind of feedback and let you know how soon. So let's see here. Oh my God, it's so close.
Nail biter, a true
is
nail biter.
a nail biter. It really is. We've got separate we've only got five votes separating first place and third place. So
Whoa.
it's still truly anybody's game. Get those votes in.
Yeah, make sh really, really make sure. I'm taking off my friendly voice now. And
Yeah, it's
saying,
not
and I'm
messing
wagging
around.
my finger.
You better get out there.
Wow, this piece by Ferris is it's unreal. It's very otherworldly all, and just wow, it's something special to me. A very unique energy. And the presence of this figure from Heather is just wonderful too. And just so impressed with her handling of the color temperature here, especially working from a black and white reference. Wow.
Yeah, it's cool. It's like those those crazy graphics people who do those colorizations on in Reddit or whatever. You submit a photo and you colorization. She's done this in her mind and has sort of rendered this in full color and even added the aspect of it that is the flower,
Wild.
which I think is a little bit of a tiny bit of a Ukraine reference here with that color blue and yellow.
Yeah, I think you're spot on with that. Yeah, I've always been impressed with Heather's work and getting an added layer of appreciation here for her color intuition. Yeah, very impressive performance tonight.
She's done a killer job, and I think that the animal first into portrait second is a winning strategy for her. I mean, I don't know specifically if it's going to win here tonight. I haven't checked the voting since I last mentioned it was pretty close, but yeah. It's so funny. This is a really good painting, actually.
And he
The
did
glow.
bring in the careful illustrative lines you can see on our blonde gnome over here.
He did. He really did, actually. And the sort of the white glow that what might be rain or just some kind of magic that's sort of splattering off of these characters is really, really, really well done. Wow. I think that
I
strategy meeting
appreciate this.
paid off.
Yeah, I appreciate this piece in my own opportunity for saying so many sentences that I've never said before. Like the careful, soft blending on these gnomes.
Yeah. Love a good beautifully executed gnome painting.
So much fun. This piece really is a lot of fun.
Amazing.
And we're also getting that kind of added story of that it was painted on the lower easel and that there was battle strategy advocation
Yeah,
involved
very cool.
before this painting.
Well, we're going to have a winner pretty soon. One painting is now 8 votes ahead. And that's not quite enough to call it. It's not going to be me calling it, by the way. I'll take care of that at the venue, but that's not quite enough to call it, but pretty soon. So stick with us. We should have the winner in only a few moments.
It's a tight race.
When's our next battle, Morgan?
We will be in Vancouver on Saturday.
Oh yeah, and I think we're gonna do the we had unfortunately some venue troubles
Oh,
in
I think we might be getting an announcement here.
Close
Oh,
for
good.
the
Let's
Lost
see.
Baron. Thank you, brother. They call me D-Sharpest host you've ever seen, aka Darnell Washburn. You know what time it is. It's time to announce the winner of the grand finale. I need another drum roll popping off. Who can help me get that started? Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Ladies and gentlemen, and the winner is the one, the only, the iconic Heather Olsen! Heather won last time, so it just only feels right that we sang that again. She's over here at easel number 3. Brilliant work. Props to everybody. Beautiful night. You can follow Heather at Heather Olsen Art on Instagram.
And a huge congratulations to our Art Battle Salt Lake City winner, Heather Olson, who has emerged victorious tonight after painting two really, truly phenomenal art pieces, each of them standing alone as just gorgeous works of art, even without the timed element, but also spectacularly as a live performance in terms of just a sheer display of skill. So huge congratulations to Heather Olson, winner of tonight's Art Battle Salt Lake City event. And also a congrats and a big thank you to all 12 of our artists who were brave enough to bring their courage and creativity to the easel with us tonight. And special thank you also to our venue team on site for making Art Battle happen. And thank you to all of you for coming and hanging out with us and watching the paint fly. And thanks,
Simon.
And
we'll see you on Saturday. Thanks, Morgan. Always a pleasure.
Bye.